Oh, wow, it's a new setup. Okay. All right, good evening, good evening, good evening. Just fix the lighting here a little bit. Peace, Simply Selvin. Good evening, welcome to Choppin' It Up. Second season, Choppin' It Up. Thank y'all for joining me these past few Sundays. I'd like to welcome y'all tonight. Tonight's special guest is the emcee, Ché Noir. Please notice I said emcee, not female emcee. Okay? Peace, London. Baby London was good. All right? Yes, so just to give y'all a heads up, season one is up, and we are on all DSPs, streaming platforms, and we are on podcast with Vivo. So if you haven't, you know, please subscribe, rate, comment, and share with all your friends. You know what I'm saying? We are trying to grow this organically. And the queen, Ché Noir, is already in the building. So for those in the chat, please say peace to the queen. I'm about to get ready to bring her in. Peace.
Hey, peace. How you doing?
Doing well, doing well. Thank you for joining me this Sunday. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, man. This is actually an honor and a pleasure. If it's okay, I can just want to give you a breakdown. You know, Choppin' It Up is where we honor, you know, the people, our guest stories. You know, so what I'm saying? And your story is actually intriguing to me. Mm-hmm. So it was only right to actually have, you know, a true emcee. I don't like to say female or male emcee. Like, I acknowledge it as what it is. So I just wanted to thank you for joining me tonight. And if it's okay, I can give you a proper introduction.
I appreciate you. Thank you. Of course.
All right. Let's go. Welcome to Choppin' It Up. This is episode 4. This is your host, Baba, a.k.a. Salim. And I'm here with the great Ché Noir. She's hailing from Buffalo, New York. An emcee with divine knowledge. Please notice I said emcee, not female emcee, because she spits better than some of your favorites. So without further ado, it's the Shea Butter Queen, Ché Noir. Welcome to Choppin'
It Up. What's up? How y'all doing?
All right. That's what it is.
What's up? How y'all doing out there? Thanks.
Good. All right. No doubt. I like to start off in the beginning and we like travel towards the, you know, the middle, then towards the president and what the future, you know, holds. So if you don't mind, I like to dig a little bit, then we can bring it up.
Okay. Yeah, I'm with it.
All right, let's get busy. All right. So growing up in Buffalo, what was the first personal memory or spark that had you gravitate towards hip hop?
Honestly, it wasn't. I mean, I grew up listening to a lot of music. You know, my mom played a lot of music around me growing up. You know, I had a lot of boy cousins. When I would go over to my aunt's house, I would hear a lot of music from being over there. I would say what sparked my love for music is I had moved to the Falls when I was like, I started making beats when I was 15. I had moved to the Falls then. Right. And I had a guy in high school that I was dating who was a producer, and he taught me how to make beats. And that's when I really started like, okay, I like this, and really like started digging into and really seeing my passion for it and that I had a talent for it too. Cause I didn't know beforehand that I really had a, like I would write stuff like little poems and spoken word. I was into all of that, but I never really got like really touched into all like as far as me being an artist and being involved in that.
Right. So I know it started out with Fruity Loops, correct?
Yes.
Right. So have you progressed any more into that? Because I know you said you've been doing some producing as of late. It's been bringing you calm and peace.
Oh, yeah. I still use Fruity Loops. That's, you know, I'm just, I always say just stick with what works for you. So I took maybe like a two-year break from.
Oh, wow.
Making beats, yeah. I had stopped making beats for like 2 years. I was okay. Still making them, but not as much as I am now. Like, I'll do a beat every like 4 or 5 months. And then, okay. Because I had started getting into rapping more full time. I'm not really making beats When I started working on After 12, that's when I really started, like, well, I would say even honestly, when the pandemic had hit, I started
Right.
around this time last year. Actually, like, probably like, yeah, around the same week last year,
Right.
2020.
Okay.
I started, you know, I had a lot more time on my hands, and I started getting back into making beats. So I had a lot of stuff sitting, and then really I went full-fledged back into it when I did After 12.
That's right. That's peace. That's peace. So, I know growing up in Buffalo and Niagara, witnessing widespread violence and poverty, can you say that has helped shape your sound?
Yeah, 'cause I mean it helps content-wise. And I always say, like, the gritty griminess, that's always been a part of Buffalo. It's been on the local scene since I was a kid. Because even when I got out here and was like doing a lot of footwork, going to like doing a lot of showcases, that's always been our lane. Because and it's authentic, because you know that's Buffalo, that's the Falls. Like you know, if you look at the list of, and it's not like, you know, it's not bragging or anything, but if you look at the top 10 most violent, dangerous cities in New York State, Niagara Falls and Buffalo trade places at number one every year.
That's crazy.
Last year was Niagara Falls, now it's Buffalo this year. Like, they trade, it's just like they go back and forth every year, every year. So,
Back and forth.
you know, definitely that's helped shape content, you know, just make it more authentic.
So, when listening to your music, you know, I get the feeling that you're like a true storyteller. You know, personal favorite for me is As God Intended, you know, with Apollo. Who were some of your, you know, influences within the realm of rap?
And I love, I mean, Nas is number one for me. Nas, Biggie, Pac. I listen, I was a Foxy Brown fan. I was into Wayne, like, early, I would
Like
say,
early Wayne.
yeah, early Wayne, like, I would say like 04 to 09 Wayne. I was into him heavy. I grew up in that mixtape era when, like, Fab and the G Unit, and I grew up, that was the era and Cassidy was a big rapper at the time. Like, that's the era I kind of grew up in.
Okay, no doubt.
But try to think, DMX. My mom was an MC Light fan. I got into her like later on. But yeah, more like, yeah, like the Biggies, Pops, and all of them, Jay-Z.
True storytellers.
Yes, storytellers, facts.
Yeah, because you know, in listening to your music, you actually, you know, I know personally for me, I can close my eyes and I can actually literally envision what you're talking about. So that's why I asked about the storyteller aspect, because, you know, sometimes here there people don't say that they have influence, but you can tell that they, you know, fall or come from a certain tree. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that's the reason why I asked who were some of your influences. So for you saying Nas, you know, Biggie and Pop, you know, that definitely explains it.
Yeah, and I like the I'm a huge fan of Kendrick. Kendrick, like, one of my favorites right now. J. Cole, like the Rhapsody, trying to think, Ciroc,
The point,
Love the Genius, Love the Genius. Like, I'm a fan of all of them. Yeah, it's a lot.
The brother D Jack turned me on to Love like 2 years ago, and
Oh yeah, that's sis. That's
yeah,
it. It's been
she's
working.
yeah, Seven is hard body. Shout out to Seven, no doubt, no doubt. Shout out to drum work too. So now talking with your brother 38 Spesh, because I had him on here about 2 weeks ago, and you know, I know he started producing and beat making as well, such as yourself. So what does producing do for you as a creative? You know, any favorites that you would like to work with in the near future on the producer's end as well?
Of course, Primo. I did a Primo beat before, but I would love to tap in more with Primo. Ninth Wonder, Havoc, Alchemist. I never rapped over Alchemist beat before.
Oh man, yeah, Al's on fire right now.
I like A-Rap music too. I think he's dope. I'm trying to think of what else. It's not coming to me now, but yeah, it's a few. I got a handful of people I would love to work with and tap in with at some point.
So what does it do for you as a creative, you know, being a producer? you know, being as though now you're saying you got back into your bag since, you know, the quarantine.
I mean, I feel like producing, being the emcee and the producer, it gives you creative control.
Right.
You control the sound, and
Right.
that's a beautiful thing. Because I don't mind, I don't mind rapping over other beats. But for me, it gives me just gives me full control. I control how the sound, how the song goes, and I got a taste of that with the After 12. Like I did the song that I got with Ciroc and RJ Payne. I had a vision for that song. It didn't initially. It wasn't like that song. The version y'all heard is not the version that was. Like she didn't record over those chord, those piano keys. Like those are. That's something that was brought in after. But I had a vision for it.
Oh, wow.
But just being able to have a vision and bring that to life was just that was different. So that's why I said I never stop and get this up ever again. I'll never get producing up again.
All right, that's what's up. That's what's up, man. You're probably gonna have some of those people that you named, you know, spitting over your production one day.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah, sure enough. You already have released a few mixtapes independently, you know, such as Poetic Thoughts, you know, Thrill of a Hunt. You know, by 2018, things started to change. How did Spesh come into the picture?
Honestly, it was a simple, it was a Facebook message I sent them of a
By
song.
chance, yeah.
Yeah, and he got back to me immediately and was like, "Yo, you are amazing.
Oh,
You
wow.
got, I got, we gotta meet. We gotta have a meeting." We talked on the phone for a little bit. Then me and my cousin had drove out to Rochester, which is an hour away from where I live at. And we had a meeting, and that first meeting, he said he wanted me to be a part of the team. So we put some work in. My first song, I would say the first verse that I did for one of his for you know, I would say my introduction on one of his albums was over a Primo beat.
Right.
Anthony Hamilton, he was on the hook. So, you know, I showed and I proved. And then, you know,
Indeed.
top of 2019, we started working on Thrill of the Hunt too. He started sending me beats. And at the time, he would send me like maybe two or three beats, like every day or two. And I knock them joints out and I drive an hour out to Rochester to record them. And I was writing and recording my verses for Trust Tape 3. So I was doing all of that at the same time. But when Thrill of the Hunt 2 came out, it was over. It just took off.
Wow, that's crazy. And you know, just to say that, to actually, you know, come out, you're spitting over a Primo beat and you got Anthony Hamilton on the hook. But did you ever think that you would be thrusted into that position that quick?
What, like, where I'm at now?
I'm not gonna front, like, you get busy, you know what I'm saying? And most people don't literally have that let's say sort of lane to, you know, get into. Like, they literally have to build up, but it's obviously they seen something in your skill. You know
Yeah,
what I mean?
I wouldn't say it was quick because by the time I got around Spesh, I was already 5, 6 years in with doing music. That was just I just look at it, that was my big break. Yeah, to rap over a Primo beat, you know, the first, you know, first meeting I had with
First
him, yeah, that
go-around,
was big. But it definitely wasn't nothing like quick or nothing. Like I was already like about burnt out. I wouldn't say burnt out, but I had put some work in already before I had met him, so yeah.
When you say burnt out and after roughly putting in about, you know, 5 to 6 years in, were you ever at that point that you were just like, I'm done with this?
I was gonna chill, and I didn't really see myself transitioning because even when I met Spesh, I still wasn't doing music full time. I would say I didn't really start going full fledged full time as an artist until Thrill of the Hunt 2 dropped. Like that was a full time rapper. Okay, I'm a rapper now. But yeah, it kind of was like I'm just doing it because I want to do it, but it ain't really my main focus until I started seeing the feedback from that project.
Real talk. Real talk. All right, I want to talk about stereotypes, if that's okay with you. As a woman in this culture, what is it like fighting stereotypes and prejudice? Yeah, and you can be honest, we can go all out, Queen.
I mean, for me, I haven't really had a huge battle with it yet. For me, I always had this self-love about myself. That's why, like, I get some people that tell me, "Oh, you gotta dress this way or look this way or do your hair this way. I've
Right.
always been comfortable with myself, so if I do or if I have experienced anything like that, I never really paid attention to it. I would say I would, only thing is I would say is this whole colorism thing with me being a
Ooh.
dark skinned woman, rapping.
Hey, talk about it. I know
Yeah,
what you I already know what you're talking about because
it's a stigma
you
on
see
that.
me.
It's a stigma on that, but it don't bother me. Like I
Right.
said, I love myself. You every
Indeed.
most of my verses I'm talking about chocolate and shea butter queen. Like I'm
Right.
talking about loving myself and my skin. So that don't it don't bother me, but I notice it though. I do.
Right.
It's definitely real.
That's peace. That's peace. That's peace. Another, I'm gonna, take it another way because we're gonna go into the thick of things, that most people I think don't honestly take heed to or honor. As a woman with divine knowledge, okay, most don't speak on the importance of education. So as a college as a college graduate, how has that assisted you in the business aspect of the rap game?
It gave me no preparation, if I'm being honest with you.
Oh wow, okay.
College was for me, that was a personal goal for myself.
Okay.
I was the first and I'm still the only person in my family to graduate from college. So that was more.
Congratulations.
Yeah, that I appreciate that. That was more of a
That's
personal
peace.
goal. I went to school for communications. I was more in the I studied film. So I plan on digging into that, but that was really no preparation for anything I'm doing in the music game. That just was more a personal goal for me. And
Right,
you know.
so I guess with the business and the rap game, that's more so been a crash course, I assume.
Oh yeah, I had to learn. It's still a lot that I learned something new every day. Like it's so much. Like somebody told me, this was like 2017, I was at a video shoot. And somebody was like, this game is 90% business and 10% music. And I did
Right.
not believe them until I got in this.
You got
It's
there.
all business. And it's a lot to learn in this. And I'm still learning. I'm an independent artist at that too. So
Exactly.
a lot of things that I'm still learning. I don't know it all. And I don't pretend to know it all. So I ask questions. But yeah, this was nothing that school prepared me for. It's just something you learn as you go. And if you got some solid people around you that ain't got this take mentality,
Right.
and really just trying to teach you the game rather than run the game on you, I should say. Spesh, I credit him a lot for what he taught me. I have a team of people like that. This guy I went to school with, he actually went to school for music business. And I remember like when I got my first piece of paperwork, and I had no lawyer at the time, and I just called him and I was like, yo, can you just walk me through what this stuff means? And he walked me through everything. Like, I
Right.
remember I was taking notes. He was like, when you go in the meeting and ask them this, and what does this mean? Like, he broke all of that down for me. So I credit my friend Ian for that. And of course, Spesh taught me so much.
Word.
It's more I learn every conversation I have with him about this game and this business.
Right. Do you get that? Do you also get that, encouragement from the rest of your trust gang brothers, like, the God Planet Asia and, Mussolini and so on and so forth?
Oh yeah, more just like the marketing, yeah, more just the marketing aspect of it. But yeah, nah, we all the team encourage each other.
Okay, that's what it is. So, I'm gonna go ahead and talk about something else as well, slick talk and introspection. 1 minute, you putting down, with putting it down with some of the best rappers, you know what I'm saying? And then I turn around and I personally listen to Daddy's Girl. Do you mean to, put that much pain out there, or you just giving more so an example for, other young queens to look at and to know that, there's somebody out there like me.
Yeah, for me, like I try to touch in lanes I never heard really. I never really heard a song where a woman talked about her relationship with her father.
Yeah.
I've heard men talk about it, I've never heard a woman talk about it before. And I'm like, I got the knowledge, and because I done been through it, so I could talk about it.
Right.
And I'm like, I know it's so many women. Like most of my friends I hang out with, we all had, issues in that department. Like more of this like daddy issues. So For me, when I wrote it, I had every intention of course, telling my story, but hoping that that could encourage women who are going through that, and just know they not, you know, they definitely not alone, because that's something I still deal with as an adult. It's dope to write songs like that, because I had a woman. Well, actually, it was her husband. He told me I was at a studio session like sign last year or something. He's like, yeah, my wife cried to that song.
Yeah. I ain't gonna front, Shay. When I heard that, you know, it touched me, because, you know, I have, you know, daughters as well. You know what I'm saying? So it just, you know, makes you, let's say, stand on your square. Make sure you're on your square so you don't leave that impression, you know, on that little girl, because later on in life, they might have a way of expressing it, and, you know, you just might hear it in a jarring way. So, you know, just to listen to that, you know, just to, I ain't going front. I think I rewinded that joint maybe over a million times.
That was the one I heard. When I got it back, I was like, oh, yeah, this is crazy. Like,
yeah, crazy. Mm-hmm. Crazy. So, I know you was talking about, you know, the crash course, you know, with the business, so on and so forth. How is Spesh, you know, sharpened your sword?
With business?
Business and with the rap game.
Well, with business, like, I mean, he there by my side and just really just put me on. Every time we link up with each other, he introduced me and put me on to something new. And even giving me that chance to be more self-reliant, teaching me some things, and then having that open line if I got questions, and, you know, answering and any questions I had to the best of his ability. But just I remember from the beginning, he told me, I just don't want nobody to take advantage of you, because you don't know nothing right now.
Right.
I still don't know it all, but I'm learning as I go. You know, he even, like, I remember from the beginning, like, when I would go up there, well, I tell this story a lot, like, the song that we did, the Primo joint with Anthony Hamilton, first verse, he told me to rewrite it, and, the first verse that I did, he told me to rewrite it, and told me straight up, like, I'm not letting up on you, you know, you definitely gotta come with it, and, you know, every song we did together, it was, listen, like, I ain't letting up. So just keeping my, that's what's helped keep my pen sharp. So I remember somebody on Twitter was like questioning if Spesh or somebody else is writing my raps because of my growth over the years. And I'm like, when you got somebody like Spesh, you got people like Benny, Class and all of them, and Ransom, coming crazy on songs.
And no doubt.
It's a friendly competition, but it's like this competitive thing. Like, that's, you know, I got a lot of that from being around a bunch of men growing up. So it's like, I'm not finna be the only girl in the song and I got the worst verse. Oh, nah.
You gotta show and prove.
Yeah. So that's what's helped sharpen my pen. Like, people see the growth and they think, oh, somebody writing for her. Nah, ain't nobody writing for me. These boys push my pen. Like, I had to be on my tippy toes with it. And the crazy thing is, like, I write verses, and I spit that joint to my cousin Corey or to my friend Miles, and they'd be like, oh, you can go a little harder. You can go a little harder, cuz. You can go a little harder, Shay. They honest with me. Like, they say, oh, that's fire. They'd be like, oh, no, you can go a little harder. So, that, man, listen, if you got the right people around you, you'll push your pen like that. So, yeah.
Well, I mean, that's good that you got people around you that's not going to pump your head up with some false information. You know what I mean?
They keep it a buck. If it's whack, that's what they tell me.
Exactly. There's a lot of people out here running around with a lot of yes men telling them that, you know,
they are not like that. They don't care how big I could be, Jay-Z big. They're going to be like, you would go harder than that, Shay. And they ain't even got to be, it's probably not even a whack verse. It's just, you can go harder. You can do better.
Right. About bringing out the best in you, because they see that.
Yes, they definitely see it. And they see what these boys is on. They see that these boys are not going light on you because you a girl, so.
Word. They're not. Yeah, no doubt. So, you know, you remind me of an emcee that likes to be in pocket with the producer, you know. So we talk with, you know, As God Intends, you know, Juno and so on and so forth. Is that how you like to work?
No, it just started like that, because me and Spesh, the first project I put out, he produced the whole thing. So that's how it started. And then We did Juno, and he produced that whole thing. I like the one producer then, I'm not gonna lie though, because
Okay. Yeah.
it's just more cohesive, and
Yes,
y'all get a
exactly.
chance to really like. It's collaborative work, but it's better like that. I like it better like that. So, even with As God Intended, like, we both had a vision for that, and I feel like
Right.
that album like shows both my side and where I'm from, and it also shows
Yes.
Apollo in that too, joint in that joint too.
Right.
So, I like that. I prefer the one producer.
And listening to your music, you seem to have a spiritual side, a
Oh yeah.
very spiritual side. So, are you strong in your faith?
Oh yes. Oh yes. I grew up in church.
Yes.
But more of it came my spirituality and just where my relationship in God and me pushing that came more as me being an adult and going through. I found my own journey. I found my hold on, I'm on an interview. Hold on, I'm doing an interview.
Oh, shoot, my bad.
Oh,
Nobody's driving by. I just wanted to say hello.
okay, thank you. My bad.
It's all good. That's all good. That's love.
But I more found my faith as an adult.
Indeed.
More of reading, praying. I start my day off with an hour of prayer and reading his word. And that preps me for my day. And even going out here in this crazy world, like I still live here. I'm still in Buffalo and Niagara Falls. And so, just me just putting that armor of protection around me, but my relationship with God, I've always implemented that in my music, because
Yes.
that's me. Like I never understand rappers who, like sometimes I be listening to rappers' music and then you hear an interview and I'm like, oh, I would have never guessed that you are this
Right.
person because you don't talk about it in your music. But for me, my
Right.
music is my identity. So why not talk about who I am? And
Exactly.
God is who I am first and foremost. So why not talk about God in my music? It don't be
That's
making sense to
beautiful.
me.
Hey, well, me personally, I like to hear it because that's something that I hear. So that's the reason, that's a main reason why I ask, because a lot of people don't, talk about it. You only get that with, certain MCs, and it's only, few far in between.
But to be honest, a lot of my favorite MCs talked about God in music growing up. DMX, Pop,
Yes.
you know what I'm
Yeah.
saying? They talked about it in their music. So, yeah, definitely. That's you gotta, like I said, my music is my identity, so I'm always just give you who I am.
All right, that's what's up. Well, you rapped alongside some really dope MCs, Skyzoo to even your own Trust Gang members, and even the great Black Thought. Okay. Any particular collabs that you may wish to happen in the near future?
Of course, the Rhapsody one. That's
Hey, Rhapsody, if you hear, sis, you know what time it is.
that'd be dope. Whenever that happens,
It
honestly, the
will.
politics of the game, though, like, I'm understanding the politics of it. So, I gotta build what I'm doing up more to
Right.
get Rhapsody to,
I feel you.
Yeah, you know what I mean. But
Of
definitely,
course,
that's
look,
definitely
trust
one of
me,
them.
I'm sure she notices.
Yeah, oh
I'm
yeah,
sure.
she know. I didn't have, I talked to her through Instagram before.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? She didn't shout him out. She didn't show love. But
Word.
like I said, people asking me about that collab. That's like a highly anticipated one. But I'm understanding the politics of this game, so
Right.
that's gonna come. But it's gotta be. I gotta. It's gotta be
The
right.
timing gotta be
Gotta
right.
make sense. Yeah, it gotta make sense. So
Exactly. You just can't be putting, things out there just for the hell of it.
yeah, that's a fact.
Yeah, it gotta make sure it benefits the whole situation indeed. All right, so I wanted to ask this, last question, because, in listening to your music, of course, I say you're a true storyteller, and then I hear the pain, but what is it that brings, Ché Noir peace?
God, my relationships, my family, my friends, like, you get a lot of sometimes the fans, they think sometimes they look at it like, oh, you be in the studio every day making 10 songs a day. Now,
Right.
I don't go to the studio as often as people think because you got to live life. I like to have content when I'm going in, so You know, you live life, take a breather sometimes, but my peace really comes from those things I listed. Doing regular things like going to the movies,
Word.
even partying. Like, I mean, I wouldn't say partying, but like, you know, I do, you know, I chill, get a night of drinks and just chilling out, talking like deep conversations with my peoples, intellectual conversations with people. Just doing regular life stuff that's not always geared towards making music.
Right. That's right. Well, that's definitely good to know, because you want to know the human side of people, not always just someone who's always giving you the music here and there, you know what I mean? So
Yeah, I'm
it's
not
always good to know
a
the person behind the
robot.
music.
I say I'm not a robot rapper. Like,
Word.
yeah, that's it's weird. I'm not a robot rapper.
True
I
indeed.
definitely live a regular life.
Word. Well, with that being said, I wanted to keep it short and sweet, but definitely to the point. You know what I'm saying? To, get the people to know your story, because that's more so our theme here, chopping it up with the conduit. We're here for the people to honor your story, but also know it as well. So, I wanted to thank you for joining me on this Sunday night. You know what I'm saying? You definitely could have been anywhere else, but I thank you for taking the time out with me. Is there anything you want to tell the people you have going on so far as maybe, some new music or, merch or, just anything you got on your plate and how they can possibly get in touch with you?
Yeah, so I'm working. I got my album, The Lotus Child, that's going to be out at some point this year. It's fully produced by me. I got other collab album. I got a my first project that I'm producing for another artist. His name is Jinx. You can follow him actually right here on Instagram, Jinx716, I think. That's
Okay.
right. But I'm producing a EP for him. We working on that. It sounded dope so far. But yeah, I'm just gonna keep working. My album, The Lotus Child, that's definitely gonna be like my main album this year. But I'm gonna have more music before that. I'm just building everything up, you know, getting it all set. I'm loading the clip up right now. So, but yeah, if y'all, I got merch on my website, ché-noir.com, ché-noir.com. But yeah, just gonna keep, I'm working, and when I'm ready to let the clip off, they'll know.
All right,
Y'all
well,
the folks.
we'll definitely be here to support you, because I see the people talking in here, and, they got major love for you, as so do I. Well, I
I
just wanted
appreciate
to thank
that.
you again. Yeah, no doubt. Thank you for joining me again. I guess you can get back to your lazy Sunday doing what you're doing. But again,
Facts.
yo, thank you for joining me, Shay. Real talk, and if anything, man, more blessings to you and more success.
More blessings to you. I appreciate you having me. God bless.
All right, sure enough. Peace.
All right.
All right, y'all. That was Ché Noir. You know what I'm saying? Upstate New York MC, not female MC. I call her MC because she spits. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my guy, Classic Material, with the dope cloth. Hip hop ain't dead. You know what I'm saying? You can hit him up at Classic Material NY. He's here on IG. You know what I'm saying? He's got the dope cloth. Super shout out to my executive producer, Mika Sunga. You're the best, what I'm saying, for pushing me in this direction. Shout out to Myron and Adam, definitely part of the team. Shout out to New Vegas Films and 1000 NYC. Yo, we definitely gonna talk. New things coming, more interviews coming up. Please subscribe. We're on Apple, Spotify, SoundCloud, and Audio Mac, and podcasts on Vivo. Please tell your friends, rate, comment, share, subscribe. Again, thank y'all for joining me, on this Sunday. Like, it's literally overwhelming. I'm really having fun with this, and I want to bring you more, organic, truthful content. So, again, I'll see you in 2 weeks. Season one is already up. Season two is up with Premium Pete. We had already released that. Make sure you go ahead and share that. We'll be dropping Wrong Streets episode next week. So again, mask up, practice social distancing, check on your loved ones. Of course, be good to yourself. Everybody have a great Sunday. Peace.